Tori's the third young lady we adopted. Again, I'm ready to stop after two. And then Mary sees a picture. She says, "Oh, Doug, look at this video. Look at this, you know." We started to think after a while, do we need to get prosthetics for her? Get into the current day, you think about 3D stuff. So we started thinking about that a little bit.
A junior studying mechanical engineering is in our group, and he was in an Uber one day talking with his Uber driver and got to talking about how he was involved in Enable, and the driver happened to be Doug.
He happened to mention that he's an engineering student and that they got a program there, Enable at Notre Dame, and they're looking for people that maybe would like to check into some 3D printed hands.
We started by taking pictures of Tori's hand so that we would have the appropriate sizing for the hands that we would make for her. And based on this sizing, we were able to take the models that are on Enable's website. We had to make some modifications to the hands in order to make room for her digit on the outside. Our group got together as a whole once we had all the parts printed so that we could put it together. This version of the hand is wrist-driven, which means that Tori is able to close the fingers in the hand by flexing her wrist, which means that all the fingers will come together. She'll be able to pick things up like softballs.
It's gonna take some time and some modifications and stuff, but I really think that at some point in time, she's really gonna utilize these 3D hands.
I hope to continue to work with a lot of great kids like Tori. Hopefully we can continue to learn a lot from the projects that we've done in the past so that we can make our future projects better and then also extend into just educating people about what engineering is at Notre Dame.